I'm the third. I'm the third generation of Finucanes. Since old Mike Finucane, my granduncle, bought this pub and business up the Ara Halia in 1898. Now, the first Ara Halia here was Michael Joseph Rahalia. The Ara Halia took the O title when he became prominent in Irish Volunteers. He was denoted as leader of the clan, like the O'er Sullivans or the O'ers. And in 1837, Michael Joseph Rahalia the First came to Ballylongford and he married a Margaret McEllistrem from Main Street. Now he was a member of the constabulary and they came from Killarney. And he married a local woman and she was the business acumen here. Her people were in business in Ballylongford Street. And my mother always said that she built up the business and she brought the business flair from the McEllistrems and she brought it down here. And they became one of the leading businesses in Munster. Michael Rahalia the First died in 1847 and left his wife, Margaret McEllistrem, with five young children. Richard, Thomas and Frank, Marion and Mariana. Oh no, sorry, stop that now. Margaret and Mariana. Now, the business after that was given to the eldest son, Richard. When his mother died, 20 years after. In 1875 he took over the business, but she already had a flourishing business built up because he was helping her in the business. And he being the eldest son, he took over the business and he had a flair for business anyway because he was an extraordinary businessman at the time. He was an entrepreneur before the world was invented. He had a great brain because he invented a cash register similar to the one here. And there was a commercial traveller over from England, from the north of England, where they bought all the farm machinery and all the other Rahalias up at that time. And Richard Rahalia showed him the plans of the register, what he was doing. And your man took it back to England and they copied it over and they manufactured it. And he spent £100 in legal fees to challenge the patent. But apparently there were some variations done to the machine and the legal people told him after taking his £100 he wouldn't win the case. So he dropped it. He was a big exporter of fish and grain, an importer of coal. He brought in the biggest coal boat at the time into Saline Pier with 200 tons of coal. And it was unknown at the time. He was into farm machinery. He was the main exporter of fish from the Shannon, salmon, oysters, herrings, all types of fish. And there were, in the backyard here, at the back of the pub, there was a big loft and there was grain upstairs and the fish business was carried on underneath. There was no refrigeration at the time. And they had to be salted and packed in barrels and taken by horse's car into the railway, the nearest railway in the store, and sent to the market from there. Now he said he looked into building an ice plant in Ballylongford. And in the meantime, he married Ellen Mangan from County Limerick. Said she'd be one of the James Clarence Mangan's relations, and which she was the mother of the Ara Halia. Now his brother Frank and and Thomas, they went to their own professions, and Mariana and Margaret were educated by the nuns in France, so that apparently they had a lot of money at the time. They were very successful merchants. And all thanks to Margaret McEllistrem, because she was really the founder. He was a constable here, but he was Michael and Harry, the first was a constabulary man, but he worked in the business as well with her, but he was more taken up with his own job and she was actually the business. And in the London Times of 1847, there was a report that when they were building Sally and Pier, the people were starving, and there was a report, a malicious rumour it was called, went around that the O'Hallys, in conjunction with a merchant in Tarbert, were bringing in a load of yellow Indian meal. And that was a malicious rumour to see if they damaged the business. And they all masked, the workers masked en masse from Sally and in here to find out and see if it was the meal landing in Tarbert. And Margaret McEllistrem met him at the door here, and she remonstrated with him and explained it to him, to the malicious rumour. That was a footnote to the famine period. And when Richard Junior decided he was going to look into building the science plant, the total cost of it was £20,000 at the time, which was an astronomical sum. And his wife, Helen Mangan, persuaded him not to go down with it, that it could break and bankrupt the company if it went wrong. So he dropped that. And he continued to flourish here, and the O'Hallie was born on the 21st of April, upstairs here in the pub. He had two elder sisters, Anna and Ellen. And he grew up here in Ballylongford, he was into sailing, he had his own racehorse, and he won the Lislachton Plate out here in the Bally races that were held outside the road here at that time, and the right hand side of the road as we were out. It was said that he rode a horse called, he called him Carrying a File, and he won the Lislachton Plate, and even then he had a racehorse and trained in the car, and he won a big plate too. And his wife came to, she was Nancy Brown from Philadelphia. Her father was a big wool merchant in textile business. And she came on the Grand Tour of Europe and to Ballydunahoe House in Tarbert, between Tarbert and Glen. And this was there the other Harry met her when he was 18 years of age. And they fell in love, and he had a successful bet in the horses, and he won a good bit of money in a double. So she was going to Paris in the meantime, and he, after winning this money, he took off to Paris after. And he left a friend of his in the university, he was studying medicine at the time, and he left a friend of his post-dated letters to send home every week, pretending he was still at university in Dublin. But the friend mixed up the letters and the dates, and he got found out anyway, but he proposed to Nancy in Paris, and they got married a few years later when he was younger, when he was 21. And his father in the meantime got pneumonia and pleurisy, cycling out, Richard O'Hallie, his father, got pneumonia and pleurisy, cycling out from the assays in Listowel. He was the resident, one of the resident JPs, the resident magistrates, and it was very funny. His father was a member of the establishment, a member of the British, whether he'd be a member of the ruling class there.